Oh yeah, we've hit a couple of these now. So DCFS is such a hopelessly bureaucratic, ineffective, ridiculous organization. They literally took children who didn't have Social Security numbers, they didn't know them, and instead of finding out what they were, they entered zeros into the computer. Just 000000000, okay? That then, when it went to switch to Medicaid Managed Care, made their applications invalid and rejected all these kids from healthcare. DCFS is the worst agency in the state on everything. But you just hit zeros, and then, hey, who cares? And then have this happen to these kids and their families, it's horrible. So we've had a couple people call us. In fact, we had a lady last week call, I think, talk to your station. Her kid has now been reinstated. The bills are going to be covered as if, you know, they should have been. But she and her family are out a massive headache and a lot of heartache in the meantime, because DCFS couldn't take the time to just find out what these kids' actual Social Security number was and put it into the computer. So instead, they entered all these zeros, and then when the computers went to transfer from one healthcare provider to the next healthcare provider, it glitched on the fact that these were invalid Social Security numbers, and then ended up denying coverage, in effect, even though these kids were supposed to be covered. It's absolutely yet another in a long litany of screw-ups at DCFS.
There's another transition for kids, I think, coming up in April here, right? I mean, do you
think that one's already been warned that they're not prepared for it. So again, I mean, look, if you look around this building, myself, other legislators on both sides of the aisle have many, many different bills to dismantle DCFS and get some common sense and some thought process into this agency. I mean, for too long, they have failed on their fundamental duty of protecting children, okay? On the west side of my district, we had a death of a poor child that should have never died. All over the state, you see that. All the way up to just stupid, insane, bureaucratic nonsense, like, I don't know what that kid's Social Security number is, so I'll just put zeros into the system. Well, that ended up being 2,500 kids that spent a month without health insurance, but thankfully they're gonna back into it. They're gonna get covered. But it's just ridiculous. If you don't know, just ask. I mean, how hard is that?
So going forward with this next transition, they've already said that, hey, this zeros problem.
I don't know that that's gonna be the next. Yeah, I don't know about. I don't know if that has anything to do with the next transition. Let's just be clear
on. Yeah.
To divorce those two. That's what happened on this one that Mark had asked me about. Was that that child ended up in being I'd say this, actually. They had 2,500 total students that got glitched. This kid was in the glitch pool of zeros.
Okay.
Because they didn't have his Social Security number.
Got it.
Okay? So to getting it, all they needed was that. So we got that. It's in the system. It's fixed now. But again, why are these people having to find out about it at the doctor's office, at the hospital, after the medical emergencies happen? You're already, as a parent, you're already freaked out and scared at your kid, and then you got the clerk telling you, hey, your insurance didn't come back valid. I mean, what? What do you mean? Oh, some goofball at DCFS just decided to enter zeros instead of the actual Social Security number. I mean, just stupid.